Hey yo, welcome to the stream. Today I'll be doing the daily quests in the UFC 3 game, and that's it for today. So let's take the free pack. And yeah, let's see what dailies I got. Elite pack. I should get this. I'm not having too much luck with the packs. I think you need all to open millions. Yeah, it's bullshit. They add something new. Nope. My record is, well, a little bit fucked up, but balanced heavyweight. Balance heavyweight. Grappler. Okay, let's start the podcast back up and enjoy.
Exact same thing. CNN, MSNBC. So we already know. Okay. So my process. Nation. You know that shit can't be
you sound like Tucker Carlson right now. What about Tucker Carlson?
There's two sides. You gotta pick one side.
Pick
one side? One side is Tucker Carlson and one side is Hillary Clinton.
No, you pick a side.
There's two sides.
I told you, don't let him go.
No, there's not two sides.
Gotta go. There's three types of people. The first one, people that think Hillary good, Trump bad. Right?
Yeah.
The second type of person is people who think Trump good, Hillary bad. And then there's the third type that think both of them are bad.
No, there's only three. We gotta stop talking to each other.
No, I'm just...
You can't do this. This is murder on people's ears.
Okay.
See, you have good ears.
I'm done.
You've done the business too long. You should know this.
You know who Dan Bongino is? He does jiu-jitsu.
Dan Bongino.
He's got his own podcast. He does jiu-jitsu.
YouTube, dude. Okay.
YouTube guy. He sometimes does shit on Fox News, too. He's awesome. You ever listen to him?
No, never heard of him.
Okay, well, if you're ever interested in a different side of what's going on, there's only really two sides in D.C. There's only two sides in D.C. There's the side that believes Adam Schiff, and then there's the other side. So for sure, Adam Schiff got in front of Congress and made up that phone call. Trump phone call. This whole impeachment's about. He gets up in front of Congress after Trump released the transcript of the Congress. Trump said, hey, look at the Biden. He's fucking on video talking shit about withholding $1 billion to Ukraine and aid if they don't fire the prosecutor that's going after his son. And he's on video saying this. So Trump says, look into that shit. And so now Trump is getting impeached.
All right, coming up next, it's a heavyweight collision between Daniel Cormier and Kimbo Slice.
Hello, Mika.
For this heavyweight fight. So 3 years the gap in age between these two fighters. Some differences in height and reach as well. Now for the official introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen,
All right, we are underway here at the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada. Left punch followed by a right. Nice 1-2 there by DC. Wow, what a kick. Huge kick lands.
Body kick, look at that. Nice leg kick.
Throwing that jab, no good. Hook to the head lands flush there by DC. Cormier gets caught with that punch. He'd be wise to get those hands up. Oh, that is as good a jab as you will see. Both guys throwing potential fight enders here in the early going.
Good kick by DC.
While the body was wide open, his opponent took advantage. Kick to the body lands flush. He's going to have to make some adjustments here moving forward.
Nice kick right there.
Landing a good series of strikes here.
Beautiful right leg kick there. Oh, double jab.
He blocks the punch. Dribbling uppercut for him there. Joey missed with that straight right attempt. Blocks the shot. Nice punch there by Slice.
Beautiful timing on that leg kick. He's blocked almost all the shots.
Cormier's attempt there is blocked by the opponent. And he connects with the punch there. Right-left combo by Slice. And he lands a nice kick. Just misses with the jab. And both guys really throwing with authority. Nice punch by Slice.
Good job of timing this combination of strikes here.
90 seconds now to go in round one.
Good kick to the body by DC.
Well done to catch the kick. We'll see what it can do. Oh!
Very good job of parrying and blocking all the shots that are coming towards his head.
I know exactly what I'm going to get if I go either the Fox or I go. When you turn on your phone, your iPhone's connected.
Oh, huge block. Slice gets hit with a kick. That one appeared to land flush. Good punch. Strong outside leg kick. Oh,
what a leg kick.
Oh, beautiful jab there by DC. Rips the body there.
please.
What sounds now is if you are a pundit, if you are a... If you're that horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one.
Nice one.
Some of the action from this round. There's a nice leg kick.
Kimbo.
And here's another beautiful leg kick.
It's so bad, and they can't really 100% like with streaming services, what's weird is like Netflix controls.
And there's another excellent leg kick.
Skippy dee doo da, skippy dee day.
Thanks very much, Ariane Celeste. Second round underway. All right, so here we go with round two. We'll see if these fighters get after it. You saw at the beginning of round one, a little bit of a feeling out process. Entertaining round, don't get me wrong, but we will see here in round two if there's an uptick in the aggression on both sides. Going to the kick here, Joe. Missed with that right hand, and he gets hit with an outside leg kick. Kimbo slices. Lower jaw is extremely swollen now.
Oh, tagged him.
See the total strikes? Man, Joe, he continues to leave that head open. His opponent's got to be salivating at this point in time. That jab has been there all night. You've got to get that head off the center line. He landed that inside leg kick. And he connects with the punch. Oh, a lot of volume here. Good series of strikes there. Back and forth we go here.
Excellent head movement.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
Absolutely.
Slice gets touched by that kick right to the body there. Nicely done by the opponent. Connects there with the punch. Much improved defensively as he blocks the shot. Kick to the body by Cormier. Well, he's landed some excellent shots in this fight tonight, but more often than not, it has been one and done. So the emphasis now moving forward, combinations. Throw your punches in bunches and really try to force the issue and get your opponent out of it. Well, his corner was pretty urgent after round one. Slackluster there in that opening round. He has certainly picked up the pace here, and as a result, he has taken control of this second round.
Really missed with that right hand.
Right hand upstairs. Nice job to get the foot off the canvas and to the target quickly. Beautiful inside leg kick by Slice. Tagged him with the overhand, Joe. Hand speed, man. Oh, he blocked that offense, Joe.
Hit him with a jab.
Slice's cut is bleeding like crazy now, Joe. I wouldn't be surprised if they come in and stop this fight. Just missed with that right hand. Oh, and he tags him with the straight. Beautifully placed there by Cormier. That punch will work right through the guard. Oh, continuing to work the body to great effect. Big shots being landed on both sides here. 20 seconds to go, round two. Kimbo Slice gets caught with that punch. He's got to figure out a way to get that guard higher, Joe.
He got tagged there.
Round three next. All right, so that's the end of the round. You know the fighter wants to be given the benefit of the doubt, but he is dealing with a nasty cut on the lip that has only gotten progressively worse as the night has gone on, and the doctor's got to protect the fighter. You know he wants to fight on. The fans don't like doctor stoppages, but if they can't nip this cut in the bud, they're going to have no choice but to stop the fight. Brittany Palmer doing her thing as usual.
Phenomenal performance that we're so privileged to be able to watch.
Oh, lands that punch. Well, he hasn't really showed any signs of slowing down tonight. He continues to connect on a high volume of strikes here.
doing a good job timing his shots here and landing a great series of punches.
Bryce's lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling.
Great exchanges. Nice right hand. This could be it. Excellent defense here. Really good job blocking all those shots coming at his head.
Oh, and he lands yet another strike to the body. Pinpoint placement right underneath the elbow. How about that shin? Just over 3 minutes now to go in the fight.
Look at that. He's timing that jab.
Trying to establish that jab once again. Kimbo Slice gets in the clinch.
Nasty kick to the body lands.
Oh, he just missed with that straight left hand, Joe. Oh!
He is clearly in big, big trouble. Oh, he's getting tagged.
Oh, big left hook there.
Vicious combinations. Wow! This could be it right here. Oh, very nice.
Throwing that jab yet again out of range.
Look at this.
Kimbo Slice's cut is only getting worse, making a nice donation to the canvas tonight. Body kick now by DC. Well, not sure if he's lighter on his feet or what it is, but these last couple of rounds, he's been far more aggressive, a lot more pressure. Oh, he's really starting to light him up now.
That's nice.
Oh, that kick is good by Cormier.
Whenever you see a fighter's legs stiffen up like that, that's not a good sign.
Punch is blocked. Oh, high-level stuff as he counters with that right hand. 30 seconds now to go on the fight. Lands an outside leg kick there. Cormier gets hit hard with that overhand. Oh, huge right hand! All right, so this one will go to a decision, and this one might receive some bonus money as well. Close fight. All right,
no, what the fuck? That was robbery, man. Hello, Ilya.
All right, with that, we are underway. Good to have you with us, as always, as we broadcast live tonight from United Center in Chicago, Illinois. Namajunas gets hit with a kick. Oh, another great combination. She is on point tonight. Trying to load up on one, and she lands. Able to check that kick as well. Namajunas has got the clinch game going early here tonight. And there is that tie clinch for her yet again. by clinch. She's got a good one. And this, oh, huge elbow!
Oh, this could be it. Big straight punch.
Trying to establish that jab once again.
Nice takedown.
Trying to spin to the back. Midway through round one. Oh, brilliant execution to land the roundhouse. Cormier gets touched by that kick to the body.
Lands a huge kick.
And now starting to snap off that jab.
Vicious combinations. Good defense there.
Establishing the jab here. Changes his stance. Oh!
This could be it right here. Big kick, but miss.
How about that shin? Namajunas gets caught by the inside leg.
There's the tie clinch again.
An elbow!
Oh, big elbow! This could be it! She might try to finish this fight here. Oh, very nice. Trying to get a single.
Oh, she lands another strike to the body, Joe. She's really starting to connect on a lot of strikes to the body. Namajunas gets caught with that punch. Cormier going for the head kick. No dice. Splits the guard and connects with the punch. 20 seconds to go in round one.
Nope. Can't get it again.
Oh.
A nice kick to the body that lands.
All right, round two.
That last round was an all-out brawl. If they continue like that in this round, someone's getting knocked out.
Oh, a big right hand, yes. Nice body work for her here, Joe. Effective punch there by Rose Namajunas.
Nice combination.
Well, Namajunas' lower jaw now starting to show signs of swelling. And she caught the kick. Well, without much resistance, she continues to find a home for that jab.
Oh!
Huge right hand!
This could be it right here. Just missed with a huge kick.
Oh! Big shots exchanged in the pocket there. Well, she's got a good jab. Missed with it there.
Oh, there it is. Full guard.
Three minutes to go.
She establishes full mount.
Cormier gets caught with that punch. We have crossed the midpoint of this fight.
Passes it to half guard. She's moved back to full guard now. In half guard now.
Posture's up now and she lands a huge elbow. Try to stay heavy here as best she can. Punch by Namajunas. Oh, nasty cut on her eyebrow, and it's looking really bad at this point, Joe. Now the elbow is the weapon of choice. Oh, now she lands some huge elbows.
Oh, nice elbow again. Transitions back to full guard.
These guys
cross guard again.
Pretty good elbow there to the body by Namayu.
Beautiful punch.
Oh, and again with the big elbow, Joe. That hurts to watch.
Good shot to the body.
20 seconds left to go in round two.
Good shot to the head.
Elbow there by Rose Namajunas.
Excellent movement on the ground here. Constantly moving, constantly staying busy.
And the horn sounds on round two. All right, so the round is over. Both fighters had their moments, but you see the cut on the eyebrows. All right, so here we go. Third and final round.
Clean punch.
Takedown lands.
Back to half guard now. Excellent movement here on the ground.
Back to the orthodox stance. Touched by that kick there. She landed that inside leg kick.
Showing that punch.
She missed with that jab. Oh, nice job defensively to get the hands up and avoid further damage there in and around that cut.
Back to southpaw again.
Well, she has landed some very significant strikes, but as yet, she has still been unable to string together anything in terms of a solid combination. And it is going to take strikes in front.
Oh, vicious knee to the body. Oh, she got stunned again. This could be it right here. Oh, vicious. Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy. Beautiful body shot there, too. Showing some good defense here, keeping control of that arm.
Less than 2 minutes with which to work here.
Oh, big knee! This could be it! Body kick, look at that!
Oh, she is absolutely getting lit up right now. She has certainly changed her approach here in the latter stages of this fight. She is trying to take the judges out of it. That'll certainly help that goal. A hit to the body by Cormier. All right, so she landed the strike there. That's the good news. Bad news, though, it just didn't do much damage. Her cardio has really abandoned her at this stage of the fight. She blocked that offense, Joe. Trying to stay heavy here as best she can. And she's back up again, so the takedowns have been there. So have the get-ups.
Whoa! This could be it right here.
And just like that, the fight is over.
And it was a beautiful...
No.
Apart. Some differences in height and reach as well. All right, here now the veteran voice of the Octagon.
He's a solid 30 pounds lighter, I think, walking around with John. That's why he's not. He doesn't want to fight him now.
And we are underway here at the Toyota Center in Houston, Texas. Opens with the left hand and lands flush.
Wham! The right and the left behind it.
Landing a good series of strikes here. Oh, she blocked the punch.
Nice. Relentless. Doing a fantastic job of blocking shots.
And just inches away from landing one of those big right hands. As she misses with the left punch there. Well, she got her head snapped back with that jab, Joe, and she continues to show a vulnerability here by almost leaning right into her opponent's range. Let's see if she can move that upper body and get her head off the center line. Shevchenko's head kick is blocked, so no damage inflicted there.
Nice punch.
And mixing it up beautifully. Oh, hook shot blocked there by Cormier. She's going back to that patented straight right hand, unable to connect. She blocks that offense, Joe. Under 3 minutes now to go in the round. Shevchenko gets touched by that kick right to the body there. Nicely done by the opponent. Double jab there by Cormier.
There was a nice exchange. Good job of timing this combination of strikes here.
Oh, she caught the kick.
Good defense there.
And there's the axe kick.
Try to establish that jab.
Nice jab.
Under 2 minutes now to go in round one. Oh, she works the body as well as anybody in this division. Another strike there, and these shots are really going to take their toll as this fight moves on. Well-placed kick there by Cormier. Well, she went to the straight left, unable to connect. Shevchenko gets caught by that flush straight punch. Nice job by the offense there. Changes her stance yet again. Trying to establish that jab once again. Shevchenko's lower jaw now, Joe, started to show some signs of swelling.
Shoots the head kick, but misses.
Wow!
This could be it right here. Oh, very nice.
Oh, straight right. Shevchenko gets tagged by that kick. That can't feel real good, Joe. Final seconds of round one. Effective strike there by Cormier. That horn sounds means we have reached the end of round one.
Let's take a look here. Here we see a perfectly timed kick, connects flush. And here's another clean shot that lands. What a great round. This fight is really shaping up.
Brittany Palmer holding it down for us here.
And, you know, I have this theory about guys who grow up with brothers that beat their asses. Like, Matthews, one of the greatest welterweights of all time. One of the things about him is he had a twin brother.
Second round underway. Oh, continuing to work the body to great effect. How about that shin? Well, she's got a good jab. Missed with it there. Changes her stance.
Look at that.
Oh, beautiful straight punch there. She is putting it all together here tonight. She caught the leg. Earlier, maybe might have gone for the takedown, but in this instance, she chooses to punch out. Nicely done. Well, without even looking at those stats bottom of your screen, you know that the most significant strike in this fight has been to the body.
Oh! This could be it. Body kick, look at that.
She's going back to the jab.
Oh, that's some wrestling right there.
Cormier gets back up. Man, she is just relentless. Unbelievable. Constantly a moving target. Oh, that kick is good by Valentina Shevchenko. Just over 3 minutes now to go.
Looking the same with that punch.
Shevchenko going for the leg kick. Nothing doing there. Well, she was a little bit hesitant in round one, but she has certainly picked up the pace here in this second round. It took her a while to find her range. She's in a strong striking rhythm now.
Good right hook.
Working on a single leg here.
Good kick.
Back and forth we go. Wow, look at that takedown, man.
Back up again.
Nice leg kick.
She blocked the ball
to the body.
Nice liver shot lands.
Hard jab.
Wow. Wow.
Oh, she got stunned again.
This could be it right here.
Beautifully timed and placed kick there by Cormier.
He has a very firm belief in what he's saying. He's also
45 seconds remain in the round.
Wow! This could be it!
Gosh. 20 seconds left to go in round two.
Someone's getting knocked out.
You can eat some meat and dairy without.
Oh, huge block for her, Joe.
Not just some meat. You probably eat quite a bit. Joe only eats meat. Listen, that's just now. Okay, this is, I'm not a good example. I've been doing it for whatever.
Shevchenko gets caught with that punch.
Oh! Back up. Good defense there.
Oh, lands that punch.
This could be it right here. Oh, that's some wrestling right there.
Oh, she blocks the punch. Well, she has landed some very significant strikes here tonight. That is the good news. The back kick right under that right elbow.
Big bully beat down. But it went too fast.
Tonight's
tale of the tape. Hello, Bedgarus.
Good defense there.
Going for the single leg now.
Oh, beautiful takedown.
Cormier gets back up again. Ooh, landed the inside leg kick there. Already a welt on her opponent. Well, she got kicked flush to the body there, Joe, right underneath her elbow, right underneath that guard. But it almost looks as though she's moving right into it. So until she makes the adjustments, you can figure her opponent is going to continue to attack that area.
Very nice kicks.
Oh, huge block for her, Joe.
That one hurt.
2 minutes have expired here in our opening round. Oh, nice punch there by Cormier. She landed that inside leg kick. Flips the guard, connects with the punch there, Joe.
And mixes it up with the kicks.
Oh, she blocks the punch. Landed a big kick there.
Hard straight punch.
Oh!
This could be it. This fight is dangerously close to being stopped.
Oh, look at that.
That would be nice.
In half guard. Back up again. Oh, man, with that right leg kick.
Nice punch there by Cormier. Oh, she works the body as well as anybody in this division. Another strike there, and these shots are really going to take their toll as this fight moves on.
Yep. Slightly deflected.
Still unable to find that precise range with the high kick.
Tries for a low single.
Oh!
Mike Bailo.
Self-interest and are allowed.
I'm saying sometimes people are such assholes you can't fucking believe it, and they're successful for it, they get rewarded for it.
I also think there's people that are doing this, and they've been doing this at a time where information, you could hold on to it. You know, you could have secrets in a way that you can't have secrets
True.
Today. I think we're
You're
just
right.
living in a totally different world.
Totally. Like, it used to be that being famous was the greatest thing ever, and now being famous, it's not so great. It's like you're just a target, you know? It's like,
it depends. You still, you have a voice. It doesn't even take the heat. Like,
I'm talking about being like a famous actor or a pop star. You're a target.
Look at Prince of England. Him and Meghan Markle were like, oh, we're fucking out. This is too much.
Are they quitting the royal family?
Yeah, they're moving to Canada. Yeah, we get the negativity. She can't deal with it.
That guy's a great fucking guy. He's a regular dude. That guy Prince Harry. He's a great Prince Harry. Is he from the royal family?
Yeah, he's a fucking guy. Have you heard this?
Just,
he's like, I don't
just
want
the idea of you being a royal. What the fuck are we talking about? We in a Harry Potter book? Is this a Game of Thrones?
It's so strange.
You're not a royal.
It's so.
That's not real. That's not real.
Well, she's the richest person in the world. Yeah.
Who is?
The Queen of England.
No, she's not.
Eddie, educate.
No, she's not.
Eddie, go. Listen to me. Listen to me. Eddie, go. The people that own the
world.
Pascal Krauss. Who the fuck is Pascal Krauss? Oh my god. I'm watching UFC for 3 or 4 years already. Pascal Krauss. Shout out to Pascal Krauss, man. You're gonna get me a bronze token. Bronze token.
Officer has spoken about some of his colleagues' attitude towards Jimmy Savile in 1960, saying that everyone Constantine didn't convert to Christianity until
exactly.
Right before he died.
No, maybe he did, maybe he didn't, but that was always like a debate about conspiracy. But that was always a debate, right? So, when you look at the Vatican, you have a lot of fucking Luciferian shit. Look at the resurrection. Look at the sculpture of the resurrection. Pull that up, the sculpture, and you tell me if that's Jesus. Look up the... This isn't
okay.
The Vatican.
Okay.
Have
you ever been to the Vatican?
I've seen a lot of videos on
you
it.
Should go. You should
it's
go.
Amazing.
Just to see it. It's pretty fucking...
It's the
church.
The church drinking the blood of Christ and eating his flesh. Look at this is their main church. That does not... That's supposed to be Jesus right there? Let's go. This is supposed... It looks like a Slayer album cover.
Well, it's that looks like Hell Awaits. It's an artist rhetoric.
That looks like Hell Awaits. Slayer, right there. So they're saying...
Pull up the...
So this is supposed to represent the resurrection of Jesus. How come you couldn't show the part? How come you didn't show the part where he's like in front of a meadow and he resurrected and there's children running in a meadow?
This is an artist. This is not like the Mona Lisa represents all women.
Yeah.
This is a guy's depiction.
Dude, this is the Vatican. This is the main church.
This is
the main church.
Can I just see what that looks like?
Come on, man.
Pull up.
It's an artist.
You
can't
sit on it. It's a Jamie. Same picture. Same picture.
It shows hell.
Just go back to the same picture.
It shows the part where he's riding on hell. You should have chosen the part.
Is that where he's in the sky?
But is Eddie, is that what it's supposed to represent?
Yes.
It's supposed to represent hell.
He's coming out of the ground. It looks like gross. Those things at the bottom aren't faces.
Okay.
Right? Are they?
It's possible. No, I'm asking him.
Arguing
with
him.
It's possible. The artist felt the same way you did. He was like,
dude, why don't you use the part where he was affected and he's on like over a meadow or something?
Maybe the artist was the Christian.
But look, hold on a second.
What
is
he coming in our mind?
Is that the ground?
That's supposed to be hell.
How do you lose resurrecting from hell?
No, I'm resurrected.
Jesus went to hell?
Why would Jesus go to hell?
That doesn't make any sense. I don't think that's in the scripture.
What is that image?
It's the art behind
it. It looks like hell to me. It looks like a Slayer album cover.
The restoration of the statue of the resurrection.
I've seen that.
That's become Satan's throne.
What is that? I've never seen that.
Depicts Jesus rising. What is that? Back up, please.
That's the main church of the Vatican.
No, I understand that. But I don't know what that represents. You'd have to talk to the actual artist. Like, if the Vatican hired someone to make an art piece about the resurrection, and this is his depiction of it, I don't know how much that has to say about the Vatican's position or about this guy who created it.
They're into Jesus, maybe.
By the way, I said Frank Bruni's gay. That's not fair.
He's a piece of shit.
Sorry, Frank Bruni.
Frank is
out
there.
Son of a bitch.
Dying dicks.
I don't know if he's gay or not, but I should have
said it. Look at the serpent of that
book. Started by one artist and then finished. finished by another artist because that artist died. It took him a generate, like it took him a lifetime, and another guy.
Yeah, it's amazing.
Who gets the credit? No one. That's what's interesting about that kind of art. It was done for God, and it wasn't done. Nobody signs it, right? It wasn't about you. It was about the larger picture, and that's the difference between architecture back then and architecture today. Architecture, like, you know, today, you see, it's about the architect. You see these incredible structures, like, you know, whatever it might be, these structures that we go and visit all the time. We don't really know. It was done by maybe one guy, then another guy. That scenario, it was commissioned by a king. You hear about the king who financed. You don't hear about the guy who built it, because that wasn't the point back then.
Was that the Freemasons? Did they build everything?
No, it was the aliens. It was Anunnaki. According to the Big Bang Theory, the expansion of observable universe began with the explosion of a single particle at a definite point in time.
Oh, we can go there.
We can go there, Jamie. Lemaitre, a Belgian cosmologist, Catholic priest, and father of the Big Bang Theory. So, Big Bang Theory. So he was a cosmologist as well as being a Catholic.
You know that, Brian? The Vatican has the biggest telescopes in the world. They have one called Lucifer. I don't think about that. They have a telescope called Lucifer. It's not the biggest telescope.
You've gone too far.
You think that's how crazy is that, right? How about it's real? That's crazy.
I feel like they have telescopes? Too far.
No, I don't think that's true. I don't think that's the biggest telescope in the world.
It's one of the biggest at one time, or it's still maybe the biggest, but it was the biggest at one time. The Vatican has been, it's a beautiful place. I love it. I was born Catholic, and I'm all down for the Catholic Church.
You have to wear a wig.
I love the cardinals. I love the bishops. I love all of them.
You're backtracking.
You should go. You should go just to see how weird it is.
Yeah. I've seen a lot of it, man. I love it.
But I mean, in person. In person, that's strange. What does it say? Lucifer instrument helps astronomers see through darkness.
It's the Vatican.
Lucifer telescope. It's in Arizona.
The
Vatican has an observatory in Arizona.
It's real.
By
Let's see
how big it is. It's amazing that the Vatican.
How about it? The Vatican is the one
amazing
behind
that
killing
the Vatican. Amazing that the Vatican. It's amazing that the Vatican would have a telescope and name it Lucifer.
Go to the click of that link.
Yeah, why'd they name it Lucifer?
Exactly. It's an acronym for something, but it just so happens to be Lucifer. Yes, it is.
No. Really? That's them.
That's what they say. It stands for something. It stands for, like, some kind of linear.
piece of equipment, nor can he give official names or nicknames to things does not own. Another group installed a telescope and nicknamed it Lucifer. That would be hilarious if you had a telescope right next to the